सेलिब्रिटी कैप्शन में आज हमारे साथ हैं बाबुल सुप्रियो. और बाबुल, सबसे पहले आदाब एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम इन द प्रोग्राम.
थैंक यू सो मच. आदाब, नमस्ते.
चलें, सबसे पहले तो हमें ये बताइए कि ये सब कैसे शुरू हुआ.
सबसे अच्छी बात यह है कि आजकल जो है ना, गूगल नाम की चीज है जो हमारे बड़े भाई है, उसमें आप अपने बारे में, आप दूसरों के बारे में जितना सही है वो भी जान सकते, जो गलत है वो भी जान सकते. जितना आपको जब मुझे अपने बारे में कुछ ज्यादा जानकारी की जरूरत पड़ती है ना, तो भी मैं गूगल में चला जाता हूँ. तो लिहाजा लोगों को थोड़ी बहुत जानकारी तो है, लेकिन आजकल क्या है, जैसे आपको मालूम होगा गूगल में हाईएस्ट सर्च जो पर्सनैलिटीज होते हैं वो ज्यादातर या तो कैटरीना कैफ होते हैं ये सलमा हायक होते हैं. तो हमारा, हमको कोई सर्च करता नहीं है ज्यादा. तो बेहतर ये है कि क्योंकि आपने मुझे थीम एयर में डाल दिया है, पकड़ ही लिया है, जैसे इन कोटेशंस एज यू सेड, मैं थोड़ी बात बता दूं. यू नो द स्टोरी ऑफ एनी आर्टिस्ट एज सच, वेदर इज अ सिंगर, पेंटर, एक्ट, स्टोरी ऑल स्टार्ट्स विद गॉड, नेचर, लक, डेस्टिनी, व्हिचएवर वे यू वांट टू पुट इट. सो माय स्टोरी स्टार्टेड विद मी बीइंग बोर्न इन अ फैमिली व्हिच इज अ वेरी रिच म्यूजिकल फैमिली, द बराल फैमिली. आई कम फ्रॉम द, आई एम द ग्रैंडसन ऑफ एनसी बराल. सो सिंस द टाइम आई हैव यू नो गेन कॉन्शियसनेस, आई एम ऑलवेज अ सिंगर. आई नेवर रियली हैड टू डिसाइड वेदर आई वांटेड टू बी अ सिंगर और नॉट, बिकॉज़ आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन सिंगिंग सिंस आई वाज 4-5 इयर्स old. I have those, luckily my dad used had a national Panasonic, the small recorders that we used to have in yesteryears. So he did record quite a few of my songs when I was 6, 5 and a half, 6, 7 years old. I still have them with me. There was a time in my teenage when I felt that I wanted to be a cricketer. During the teenage that I realized that my natural ability to sing was superior to my natural ability to play cricket. Prior to that, you know, my grandfather extensively taught me music. So I'm a pure born with the Rasgullas and Dohis and everything that you hear about Kolkata. I've been learning music from him since maybe I'm 5 years old, and I have twice been the All India Don Bosco School music champion. I still do hold the largest number of inter-college medallions. So it was that time when I realized that this is one quality that I've been given by nature or God for free. And I needed to do something with that. While I was finishing my honors course in BCom, I did get a job in Standard Chartered Bank, which is a British bank, as you know. So being the only son of my dad, a lot of pressures, and no one wanted me to jump into this bandwagon of uncertainty in Bollywood, in Bombay, a city that was completely alien to me, a language, Hindi, which was completely alien to me, apart from the fact that I used to sing Hindi songs. So I worked in Standard Chartered for 2 years, but I realized that everyone apart from me was happy, that, you know, my life has probably fallen into place. But I knew that it was not the right thing that I was doing. I was counting others' money. Rather, I should count on my own chickens and let them hatch. So what I could do was hitchhike from Kolkata. Mm-hmm. And ran away to Bombay. One fine night, I had a huge fight with my dad. I just sat in a general compartment in an Indian train and came to Bombay. And that's how it all started.
You talked about your grandfather. Jahan tak mujhe pata hai, he was a very famous Bengali vocalist and composer.
Composer, yeah.
So,
right, yeah.
Pressure tha shuru se?
I would rather say there wasn't any pressure, because see, he was a BA LLB lawyer from the British era. Mm-hmm. You know, that was the time he had a lot of long playing records with the leading record label in India called Megaphone. But that was a time when there wasn't much money in music. Like the cricketers have started making money now. There wasn't much money maybe 25 years back, 30 years back. So my grandfather was not at all, he never really made money. Rather, choosing music over a career that he could have had in law, being an LLB, he actually faced a lot of hardship during his, during his lifetime. None of them could actually jump into music because there wasn't any money. And somehow my father or my uncle felt that it was too huge a risk to be taken. So there was no pressure, absolutely no pressure on me from my grandfather's side. But yes, if you talk about, see, there are two sides to this. One is you sing for your own self, and you sing well. Mm-hmm. And the other one is you just sing for money to make your passion into your profession. So the pressure of being a good singer, yes, that was always on me.
Family ne support kiya tha when you have decided, okay, I'm gonna just leave a very good job and gonna go, and I mean, obviously it would gonna be a struggling phase that time in music scene.
Well, I didn't expect anyone to support me. In fact, my parents were very distressed. They were devastated, rather. There was a Bollywood scene at the train station in Howrah bus station in Calcutta where, you know, my mom was crying, my dad was saying, okay, last one chance, you know, don't do this. My mother carrying a steel tiffin ka dabba in which there was roti and dal and there was to have it in the train. And there was an absolutely retro Bollywood scene that was happening in the station to stop me from making that move.
Mm-hmm.
I really did not know anyone in Bombay. But I really knew one thing, that what exactly my heart desired at that point of time. That was very important. I'm glad I heard myself. And see, at the end of the day, it's one life, one chance.
Exactly.
If I made it, good, fair, good for me. If I did not make it, I would have been one other guy who came to Bombay, did not meet his dreams, would have just, you know, disintegrated and vanished somewhere in the doldrums. Every artist goes through a struggle and goes through hardship. You have to go through a struggle, and I don't talk about my struggle. I never say anything about it because I think it was a very legitimate phase in my life, and that is what made me who I am.
Khoya khoya chand rehta hai aasman ke paas, khoye khoye hum bhi rehte hain is jahan ke paas. खोया खोया चांद रहता है आसमां के पास, खोए खोए हम भी रहते हैं इस जहां के पास. इस जहां के पास खोया खोया क्यों रहता है आजकल ये दिल, तो मेरी जान समझती हो क्या मेरी मुश्किल. सारी सारी रात जागू मैं चांदनी के साथ, बस में
especially that time, we're talking about the time in 90s when there was an era of Kumar Sanu, Udit Narayan and the big names, you know, who ruled the industry like the Bollywood for years and years. I mean, saying that, did you had like this thing in your mind? I mean, it's going to be a bit tough for me.
Yeah, I had it very much in my mind. Not only that, you know, to be very honest, Shanuda, Kumar Sanu, Udit Narayan, Abhijit, they are one, there are previous generation. Myself, Shan, Sonu, KK, we are the next generation. And we had to wait. It is 92, 93, Udit Narayan, Kumar Sanu, they were at the beginning of their career. They were absolutely at the beginning of the careers, and we were ranked newcomers all in our 20s. Like, I mean, not even, we were all early 20s. I was 20, Shan was 19. So that was the time when we were struggling to get one song here and there. In the initial stages, I was called a Kumar Sanu clone because whenever I went on stage, the songs that I was requested to sing were all Nadeem Shravan, Anu Malik songs, and 90% of them were sung by Kumar Sanu, or maybe say Udit Narayana, Pahla Nasha, or Abhijit Da, maybe a Main Koi Aisa Geet Gaun, or we never had a songs of our own, and I was very sure that I'll have to wait because Bollywood never needed a new singer then. I still remember the day, you know, when I met Anu Malik in the Sunny Studios. Mm-hmm. The Sunny Studios is where all the big pictures of songs were recorded. Chugglers used to just go there and, you know, check out what is happening, who is the one recording. So, thoda struggle either other, hi, hello, bolna, namaste, karna, he said, chalta rehta. So, I still remember a day when, you know, there's a film called Main Khiladi Tu Unari. Wo gana tha, bada famous gana tha. Paas wo aane lage zara zara, darkane churane lage zara zara. And I remember Alka Yagnik had come and sung the song, and the unit was waiting for Kumar Sanu to come and sing the song, mm-hmm. the first floor. And that's when Anu Malik, you know, he walked down the stairs. When me and a couple of other guys, we approached him. We were just trying to, we knew nothing would come out of it. You know, he said a very peculiar thing. He asked all of us what we did, and then he came to know from me that I was working in Sanitara. So he said that, why do you want to waste your life? And let me tell you, give me an answer to this question. Give me one good reason why I should give you this song. Kumar Sanu sang Bazigir for me. He had won the film there. Udit Narayan sang so many great songs. Abhijit sang so many great songs. So I have four great singers in my hand. Give me one good reason why I should discard all of these people and I give you a song in such a huge film. Mm-hmm. And trust me, talking, I never had an answer. I still remember after having faced that question, I not only replied to him, I was quiet. And I remember walking back to the balcony where I stayed. I never brought any money from Kolkata. I wanted to struggle and start absolutely from scratch because then there were no reality shows, so there were no money. We were not doing shows. I walked back and I still remember for the entire evening, I was sitting quiet in one of those corners of that neighborhood and thinking that, really, what is the answer? And then as they say that, you know, a hero lies within you, something inside me told me that, Babul Supriyo, you need to be patient. I kept on singing, thanks to Tips, Venus, T-Series, they gave me a lot of walk-ins in versions, in Kishore Kumar numbers, this, that. So I got to know the mic, and I think that was the base which got me, Saath Rang Ke Sapne Aati Hai To Chal, Tu Mere Saath Mein, O De De Saathiya, Haathon Ko Haath Mein. Then there was, immediately after that was, Hata Saavan Ki Jata, Salman Bhai Ke Liye. Ye Sapno Ka Wo Raja, Mere Dil Ka Wo Raj Kumar, Main To Uski Diwani Banungi, Us Pe Aane Laga Mujhko Pyar, Karta Hu Uska Main Ab Intezaar, Ye To Hai Tujhko Pata. This was a song, this was the first time that I heard, you know, auto rickshaws playing. You suddenly find that your song is playing in the auto. And it actually happened in my life. So those are huge kicks. And I enjoyed every bit of that struggle. Rajesh Roshan used to tell me that, you know, don't lose her heart. Keep on coming to me. I will give you the right song. And that's when, in 2000, he gave me Kahona Pyar, the enigma that descended upon Bollywood and world cinema in the name of Hrithik Roshan was so huge, so luminous that everyone got a share of that limelight. And I was one of those lucky ones.
Don't you feel like your voice is very similar to Sanu, Kumar Sanu's voice?
In the initial days, see, Sonu Nigam was very close to Muhammad Aziz. He was called a Muhammad Aziz clone. Kumar Sanu was called a Kishore Kumar clone. Even if you see Lata Ji, it was said that she in the initial days sounded very similar to Noor Jahan. Kishore Kumar, initial songs, you can't even recognize whether it is Kishore Kumar. So you have an idol. You have a when you enter the industry, you don't have your own songs. So, I mean, 94, a rank struggler myself, going to UK, I had performed with Amitabh Bachchan there in UK at the Wembley Stadium, I remember. So you want me to sing Kuch Na Kaho on stage. Why would the audience listen to Kuch Na Kaho in Babul Supriyo style? Who the hell is Babul Supriyo? I was just a noun.
Mm-hmm.
So I was expected to sing a popular song in the manner in which it was made famous. So when I said, Pehla Nasha, Pehla Humar, I tried to be like Udit Narayan. When I sang Kuch Na Kaho, I tried to be Kumar Shanu. When I sang Aisi Deewanagi, I tried to be like Vinod Rathore. So that was part of the challenge. That was part of my struggle. The important part was not to lose heart and to believe that, you know, you will have to go through a very legitimate... Asha Bhosle was said that she was so close to Geeta Dutt. So we all have to go through that phase of identity crisis. But if you're courageous, someday or the other, you will get to be known as your own self. And that's what happened.
Isn't it kind of like a good feeling as well? I mean, after, let's say, like, I've heard your voice in Kahona Pyar Hai, Sitaro Ki Mehfil Mein, and for a minute, I couldn't realize, is it Kumar Sanu or is it Babul?
From Kahona Pyar Hai, I wouldn't say. I would say that songs prior to that, I would say Kahona Pyar Hai I was used particularly for a voice which sounded different from the Hrithik Roshan that was in the first half and died later on. So I sang for Hrithik Roshan, the second Hrithik Roshan who was in Australia.
Yeah.
You go by the story of the film.
Mm-hmm.
So my voice was meant to be different, and that's exactly what it was. In the first half, Kumar Sanu, being Kumar Sanu at that point of time, he sang, Chand Sitare Phool aur Khushbu. He sang that in the first half.
Mm-hmm.
And in the second half, they were looking for a voice which they wanted to sound a little different from what it was in the first half. And that's how I came in. So, Kahona Pyara never really... But see, I don't argue when it comes to an audience's reaction. You have to... I mean, there is nothing wrong in hitting a straight drive which is as straight as the way Tendulkar hits it for a newcomer. So, Shanoda was so very senior to me. You know, I would like to play a scoop shot as good as Dilshan. So similarly, at that point of time, if I sang a great song on stage for any of these senior singers of mine, I would have loved to sing it the way as well as they sang it. So after Kahona Pyara Hai with Tera Jadoo Chal Gaya, Dhai Akshar Prem Ke, I immediately carved a niche for myself. Then Hum Tum Aate Aate, Chori Chori, Chupke Chupke, so many songs that came one after the other. It takes the audience a little bit of time to identify the timbre of the voice, the texture of the voice. Once you identify that, then you can really make out between singers. I think that is the reason why today there are n number of singers,
mm-hmm.
but you will not find too many proper nouns. You will have to search who sang a particular song. They sing one song or two songs and then they go into the oblivion. It is a little unfair that music directors don't continue to use the same singers, or at least don't try to give them 4-5 hits in a row. Unless and until you get 4-5 great songs in a row and people get to hear you consecutively for 4-5 songs, they're not going to get accustomed to your particular type of voice or your timbre. Where am I different from the other singers? It'll take a little bit of time for people to register that. And I was lucky, during the early 2000s, I actually got that period. That was the time when I sang so. So chuta hoon uska dil kabhi mujh pe aaye to jaan bhi use de do main wo kisi tarah mujhe aazmaaye to aaye to aaye to. See, that song won me the MTV award.
Yeah.
So these are songs that koya koya chand rehta hai आसमां के पास कोई कोई हम भी रहते हैं इस जहां के पास. So this one was a big hit. Then Rehman, A.R. Rehman called me to Chennai to sing a couple of songs for him. One of the songs was a big hit. ये खोया खोया रहता है ये दिन में सोया सोया रहता है ये रातों को उठ उठ के रोता है ये कहता है कि ले गया दिल तरड़म पम तरड़म पम तरड़म पम चलो उसको ढूंढेंगे हम. These were songs that came मेरी तरह तुम भी कभी प्यार करके देखो ना चाहत का मुझ पे सनम इकरार करके देखो ना. देन हमने तुमको दिल ये दे दिया ये भी ना सोचा कौन को तुम ये फैसला जो दिल ने किया ये फैसला जो दिल ने किया. सो दे एस्टैब्लिश मी एज मैंने कोई जादू नहीं किया तू ही मेरे पीछे आया पिया अखियां मिला के तुमने दिल को चुराया लुटा 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 मेरा जिया. Then there was one very big hit in London. People used to listen to that a lot. I heard it playing in all the radio stations. Jina sirf mere liye, jina sirf mere liye, ye din ye mahine sa. So that was the big hit in London. Aate aate aa gaye paas hum, jaate jaate le gaye tum sanam. And then of course in 2004 Hum Tum came. To that I was singing a lot of fast numbers. After Hum Tum I got to be known as a singer with soft romantic voice, and that was one change in my career. Soft romantic song happened.
Kuch dino se dil mera bechainiya sahe dhoondne koi rasta kaise tumhe kahe. दिनों से दिल मेरा बेचैनिया सहे ढूंढ कोई रास्ता कैसे तुम्हें कहे. जो हुआ हो गया थी जो शिकवे गिले वक्त की कब्र में वो भी दफन हुए. रह गई कुछ यादें और तन्हाइयां आज तुमसे कहती है मेरी खामोशियां. का तेरे साथ का shukriya har subah ki us coffee ke liye world's best bulakad ke coffee ke liye raat bhar sofa par karna wo intezaar bhul gaye yaad hai aisi baatein hazaar ab na tujh pe haq hai na tujh pe hai koi zor dil se sadaaye bas aa rahi teri yaad shukriya tere pyar ka tere saath ka shukriya कहते हैं ये जो जिंदगानी है ले जाए कहां कोई जाने ना चार दिन की छोटी सी कहानी है इसे खुशियों के पलों से सजा बिन बुलाए आती है रुलाती है यादों की है आदत ये बुरी ही फिर धीरे धीरे धुंधली सी हो जाती है वक्त की है ये जादूगरी भूली बिसरी यादों में हम भी रह जाएंगे जाते जाते इतना ही तुमसे कह जाएंगे
You're one of the singers जिनको चांस मिला कि उन्होंने बहुत सारे आर्टिस्ट के लिए गाना गाया उनके डेब्यू मूवीज में इफ इट कम्स टू डिफरेंट नेम्स फ्रॉम ऋतिक
ऋतिक रोशन तुषार कपूर दीनो मौर्या अभिषेक बच्चन नॉट द डेब्यू बट अभिषेक बच्चन रेफ्यूजी एंड ढाई अक्षर प्रेम के हैपेंड ऑलमोस्ट इन द सेम टाइम सो इट वाज वेरी मच अ डेब्यू फिल्म फॉर हिम
एक तरफ आप पॉप सीन पे भी आए और देन यू हैव गॉन बिग विद खोया खोया चांद एंड देन यू काइंड ऑफ लाइक आप एकदम गायब हो गए पॉप सीन से एंड यू स्टार्टेड फोकसिंग मोर ऑन द बॉलीवुड प्लेबैक सिंगिंग हाउ डिड दिस हैपन और यू हैव लाइक सेट अ प्रायोरिटी दैट इट ऑलवेज गोना बी अ प्लेबैक सिंगिंग दैट्स व्हाई आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू
दैट वाज नॉट माय चॉइस द पॉप इंडस्ट्री सीजेस टू एग्जिस्ट राइट नाउ इन इंडिया थैंक्स टू पायरेसी थैंक्स टू द फैक्ट दैट यू नो द radio stations and the television channels, the music channels, they don't promote non-film anymore. I mean, let me give you an example. Like, take my contemporary singers. There are few lucky playback singers who has a couple of hits in the non-film arena or has a pop career apart from their filmy careers. Like myself, Shahan, Sonu, KK, Lucky Ali. Just think about it. I mean, Adran Sami's Kabhi Toh Nazar Milao, Shan's Tanha Dil, My Sochta Hoon Aur Khoya Khoya Chaand, Sonu Nigam's Diwana, KK's Pal. These are all albums that we have done from, at least 5 years back. These songs are still popular. They play on the radio. We still have to sing it in our live shows. What is happening? What happened to the latest albums that we have done? Not that we have not done albums after it. Mm-hmm. All of us have done at least two albums after these super hit albums. Because in the industry, you get work from work itself. If you have done good job in something, obviously you're going to get a lot of offers. Why didn't the later albums of any of these artists? What is Adnan Sami's next album after Kabhi Toh Nazar Mila? Tell me. What is Lucky Ali's next album after Suno? People are not aware of it because the radio stations, the FM stations and the television channels, they stopped playing non-film altogether. It was only about Bollywood.
Is there something to do with the promotion?
They did not promote it. That's exactly what it is. You know, like when Sosna was released, even now, when my last album, Untitled, was released from Universal Music, I was the MTV Artist of the Month. I was the Channel V Artist of the Night. But tag lines were given to us. The rotation of the songs were only twice a day. Didn't take the songs anywhere. During Sochta Hoon, if you were the artist of the month, your song played 13 times a day. Now you watch any music channel otherwise in India, you will only find reality shows being played in there. There's Splitsville and all of that being played in MTV, this, that. So they're not playing videos anymore. They're not promoting non-film songs. Radios, FM stations have categorically decided not to play non-film. Now you cannot really blame the FM station. There's a larger picture to it. The sponsors are saying that if you're playing new songs, then we don't want to sponsor that particular art. So you'll have to play Bollywood. So there is a huge vicious circle that happened, and that is because the reason why even the biggest of pop stars who were not Bollywood but only pop, whether it is Alisha Chinoy or maybe even Dilip Mehndi, I mean, where are their albums? Where are they? They don't feature anywhere in the non-film film because of piracy, because of reluctance of the television channels and FM stations. The non-film scene has absolutely been killed. Look at the greatest of Ghazal singers. Pankaj Udas, Talat Aziz, Hariharan, they're all at their prime. I mean, Ghazal singers are not supposed to be 20, 22 years old. They're all in the 50s, 60s. They're all so fresh. Their live shows are selling like anything, yet they do not have an album. Why? Because there aren't people, there aren't music companies that are they're willing to support. And a lot of the blame has to go to the audience, because for everything else you want to pay money, but when it comes to music, you want to listen to good music but you don't want to pay for it. So you are downloading, people are downloading rampantly from the internet. And when the music companies, when they're investing on an album and not getting handsome returns from it, they're going to stop promoting new talent. And that is the reason you might have n number of reality shows happening on television, but name me one reality show star that you can recall who has a hit to his name. I even know young guys who have come from the UK, stayed in Bombay to take part in the reality shows. I know people coming from all over the world, from Afghanistan, from Dubai, from London, from America, from Australia. People come to get into Bombay, to get into Bollywood and take part in reality shows. And a couple of them have actually made a name for themselves. They won it. They couldn't speak Hindi, but yet they could sing Hindi song. But what happened to them after that? They're just doing live shows, and doing too many live shows at a very young age is destroying your own voice. So the playing fields have been destroyed because of this socio-economic change in music industry, where no one is promoting new talent in non-film. And that, I think, is the arena from where new talents can come out, because everyone cannot get a jump start in Bollywood. So it is not happening. And that's the reason why you're not getting albums from any of these winners that are coming out of these reality shows that are so popular on television.
Then where does Love Is In The Air came across, or kahan se wo idea aaya, or where does this all started with the concept of having so many singers?
It was a dream project of mine. I always, as you know, taking a leaf out from what I was speaking for the last few minutes, that you know, people weren't promoting non-film albums. So I felt that the concept of singles did not really exist in India. So instead of having an artist or a company spend heavily on making 8 songs in an album, why don't we compile an album? Why don't we make an album of singles? Singles concept really cannot work in India, where you release just one song. That cannot really work in India. So we were thinking of doing I had an idea that we are going to make an album where we are going to have one new song by different popular singers. And I've been toying with the idea and discussing with different FM stations for the last year and a half, Reliance Big FM, who really loved the idea. Mm-hmm. And that's how, when I spoke to my colleagues, I spoke to Shan, I spoke to Shankar, I spoke to Alka Yagnik, there was Javed Ali, and there was Neha Bhasin, who recently sang one or two good songs. So we all agreed that it was a great idea, and we had Big FM promoting us on air, putting hoardings in Bombay and all of that. They supported it, and that's how we all contributed one song towards the album. It was called Love Is In The Air. There was a lot of media support and stuff, but yet we did not manage to make videos to the song. When you don't manage to make videos to the songs don't reach the audience as much as they do when they are featured in a Bollywood film. So there are a couple of gray areas that exist in non-film, and I think that those gray areas are going to exist for a few more, for a little longer while, and then let's hope that something changes, some new avenue comes out where non-film music can get its due, and in a way we can have new talents doing this non-film song.
मेरे दिल की बात जब तेरी यादें कम होती है एक लम्हा इंतजार फिर सुनी आंखें नम होती है सुनो मेरे दिल की बात जब तेरी यादें कम होती है एक लम्हा इंतजार फिर सुनी आंखें जब रुक जाती है उस पल में बेकरार फिर रातें दूर हरदम होती है सुनो आंखें मेरी कम सोती है
अच्छा मुझे ये बताइएगा सिंगिंग पे हमने काफी बात कर ली बाबू एन एक्टर ये कहाँ से एक्टिंग कहाँ से शुरू होगी जनाब ये जो रास है उठाएं जरा पर्दा
पूरी पूरी दुनिया में जो है जो भी एक्टर्स हैं वो जब जो भी सिंगर्स हैं जब भी वो एक्टिंग में आते हैं तो कोई बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं होती है हमारे सामने हजारों ऐसे एग्जांपल्स हैं जब सिंगर्स जब सक्सेसफुली यू नो गॉट इनटू एक्टिंग वेदर इट इज अ वन ऑफ थिंग और वेदर इट इज डूइंग अ कैमियो और वेदर इट इज डूइंग इट कंटिन्यूअसली फॉर अ यू नो और टेकिंग इट एज अ पैरेलल करियर देयर इज नेवर रेज्ड क्वेश्चन आई थिंक इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द इम्प्रूडेंस और क्वाइट फनी व्हाट शुड आई से फनी situations created by a few of my contemporaries that you know getting singers getting into acting has become such a laughing stock in India or in Bollywood rather
mm-hmm.
acting did not you know it was not something it has always been a passion of mine in my college days I used to do a little bit of theater and all of that but it was never there in my mind but I did three very big Bengali films Bengali being my mother tongue is a huge Bengali film industry Satyajit Ray and Mrinal Sen everyone is aware of that so I did three films in Bengal and the opportunities came to me you know it just happened to me I went to sing a song and Tarun Mazumdar Sundar, one of the legendary directors in Bengali, said that, you know, I like your body language, would you want to act? Mm-hmm. So I jokingly said that if he launched me, so he did. So I did three films. I did a negative role, a small negative role for Sandeep Ray, Satyajit Ray's son's movie. Then I did the Bengali adaptation of My Fair Lady, Bernard Shaw's Pygmalion. So I did that. Those films did well, and luckily I would say that, you know, the response was very positive. I mean, the answer to the question as in whether Babul Supriyo should have at all tried acting was 95% yes. And I have always loved taking risks. And I think the biggest, you know, the biggest sickness that exists in the industry is not, exists in the human creed is not really cancer or AIDS. Maybe it is a fear of what others might be talking about you.
Yeah.
It's a fear of what others think about you.
Mm-hmm.
And that is one thing that I don't really suffer from. Mm-hmm. I'm very carefree in my own ways. I really care a damn what others might be saying. I am aware that the fact that I'm starting shooting my first Bollywood film from the 12th of this month, in another 6 days, I'll be going to Bangalore. The film is called Jovi Carvalho. Mm-hmm. It's out and out comedy movie, which has features Paresh Rawal, Arshad Warsi, Soha Ali Khan, Javed Jaffrey. And I'm doing a very small cameo. My portion in the movie is not going to be more than 20 minutes to half an hour. But then back to the basics. When I started music, singing, I used to get 2-3 lines in a song, 4-5 lines in a remix song. If I love acting, if I loved being behind the camera, so I'm not really dreaming about starting with a bang or something. Let me take small steps. If it is meant to happen, it will. If it doesn't, yeah, I really don't care. You know, responded mm-hmm. to my heart's desire.
As you said, like in the start of interview, people usually watch Katrina Kaif. So we're probably going to end up having a look at Babul Supriyo acting opposite to Katrina Kaif in some movie as well in the future.
You know what? Sometimes dreams are best featured when they feature in your dream. To be very honest, you know, even when I'm getting into films, when I'm reading, trying to do a few things, a few opportunities are coming to me. Music does not even feature anywhere. I mean, it is not a precondition, or I'm not expecting that if I'm in a film, I'm going to get a song in that I'm going to sit on a piano and sing a song or something. What you said, it's better that I don't react. You know, let it go as one sweet moment that you have created for me on radio. And it is not even going to put me on air in any kind of relation, because I know I'm going to drop very hard.
Actually, you tell me, the kind of music you like and the kind of music you produce, if you have to explain it in like few words, what you're going to say about it?
See, there are only two things that exist. It's either good music or noise. So I listen to all kinds of music. I listen to dance music. I mean, as human beings, you go through different kinds of emotion throughout the day. So when you're happy, you might want to dance. You play to dance. You dance to dance music. You know, today you might even want to dance to Gangnam, you know. And when you're sad, you might want to listen to a soft number. Mm-hmm. When you're in love, you might want to listen to, you know, a romantic number. So I love music that suits my mood at a given point of time. So depending upon what particular mood I am, I listen to the kind of songs that I listen to. So I am basically fond of melodious music. I don't like very loud, abstract music, but I will not really subscribe to hard rock, hard metal.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, I am avid music listener, and I really know I'm not prejudiced towards one particular kind of music.
people who wanted to get into the music scene, या जो आना चाहते हैं, what kind of like, I mean, having said that, कि आपने इतना सा इस सीन में गुजारा है, you've struggled and you have made a big name for yourself, क्या मैसेज देना चाहेंगे उन्हें?
Well, I'll tell you one thing that, you know, today there are a lot of shortcuts to make great studio product. Like Bollywood right now have settled for mediocre singing. I mean, there are a lot of famous singers who are not even singers. They don't even qualify as being singers, as being called singers. But there are great softwares. So these singers, they can come up with great studio products. Like there are a lot of British artists. I don't want to name them. There are groups, there are bands who are, neither of them are good singers, but they have come up with great studio products. They have come up with huge hits. So I would tell the youngsters that, you know, it's great to be famous. That's all you want, to be famous, to be recognized, to be loved by people. So if you come up with a great studio product and the product hits in the market and it becomes famous and you become a great artist, then work on your singing a little bit as well. It is not really, it's not nice to go on stage and lip sync to a song when you are telling your audience that you're doing a live performance. So I think you're going to gain a lot of self-confidence and also a lot of self-respect. Plus respect from your audience. If apart from being known as a famous singer, you're also known as a great singer. It's very important to be a very good singer while you're trying to be a famous singer. If you're very lucky, if you can make it into being a famous singer without being a singer at all, which there are several examples, good for you. But while you remain famous, work hard to at least, you know, sing live to your audience and not lip sync on stage as we see it happening so many times. So those are shortcuts that I would tell my young brothers and sisters to avoid. And I think if they push themselves, nothing really is impossible. If you can really push themselves, if someone gets a hit, a super hit in the musical industry, then you'll have to admit that there must be something lying for them ahead in that particular road. So probably nature is giving you a signal that, okay, I have given you a hit first. Now it is your job to become a great singer and work hard on your singing. That's all I need to say, that to be a famous singer, it's great if you can also be a great singer.
Chalein, great. Bahut bahut shukriya for taking the time out. Aur secondly, ye ki aise tumhain kisi ko jaane nahi deta, you have to sing a line or two of any of your favorite song, kyunki itni achhi awaaz ko aise jaane diya jaye, it's not fair.
Zarur gaayenge. I will sing the song from Hum Tum, which I think is one of the best songs of my career. I'll hum a few lines, and I think this is the time, this is the festive season, this is the time when all the hums and tums, they should all get together and come closer to each other. So I think it perfectly suits the occasion as well. Saanson ko saanson mein dhalne do zara, dheemi si dhadkan ko badhne do zara. लम्हों की गुजारिश है ये, पास आ जाएं हम तुम हम तुम, आँखों से हमको उतरने दो जरा, शर्मो हया को मचलने दो जरा. लम्हों की गुजारिश है ये, पास आ जाए हम तुम हम तुम. सांसों को सांसों में ढलने दो जरा.
Thank you so much, Babul, for giving us
time. Thank you so much.
अपना बहुत सारा ख्याल रखिएगा बाबू, एंड गुड लक विद ऑल योर प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड एवरीथिंग.
गॉड ब्लेस सर. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.
सांसों को सांसों में ढलने दो जरा. लम्हों की गुजारिश है ये, पास आ जाए.